Hello friends, today we are going to determine the modulus of rigidity of the material of a given wire using Maxwell's needle. So in this experiment, we require a rigid support. The Maxwell's needle is hanging from this rigid support using this metallic wire. This is the wire whose modulus of rigidity we are going to find out. So this metallic wire is totally vertical and the Maxwell's needle is totally horizontal in this setup. And we also have a mirror at the center of Maxwell's needle. Along with this, we have a metal pin and two identical solid cylinders and two identical hollow cylinders we are also going to use in this experiment. In the first step, we are going to insert solid and hollow cylinders in the Maxwell needle. So we are placing them in such a way such that we insert solid cylinder inside and hollow cylinders towards outside of the Maxwell needle. So this is our first arrangement of this setup. After that, we will place this needle in front of the mirror and will observe its image in the telescope. The size of this needle is big, so it is difficult to find that when this needle is at its mean position. So we use this method in which when the image and the object coincide, it means we consider this as the mean position of its oscillation. So here we start our experiment in which solid cylinders are inside and hollow cylinders are outside. Now we will gently apply a force and oscillate this and switch on your stopwatch. One thing you should take care in this step is that the motion in Maxwell's needle should only be horizontal. Now we will make a table of it. Each time observe the time for 10 oscillations and repeat this experiment 2 more times. In this way you are observing time of 10 oscillation 3 times. After that, you can have a mean of it. And finally, to get the value of the time period of one oscillation, we can divide it by 10 and call it as T1. In this way, we have gathered information of time of oscillation when the solid cylinder are inward. Now, let's change the position of hollow and solid cylinders. Now, hollow cylinders are inward and solid cylinders are outward. In this position as well, we will repeat the same step and observe the time of 10 oscillations 3 times and have a mean of it. And finally, we will get the time period of 1 oscillation for this arrangement and we call this as T2. Along with this, we need some other parameters in this experiment, like we require the length of the wire. We also require the length of the needle, which we are considering as 2a, and further we will calculate this quantity a. All these parameters should be in SI units, means meter. After that, we also require the mass of hollow and solid cylinders. So the mass of hollow cylinder we are considering as m1 and solid cylinder we are considering as m2. Write them in kilogram. Finally, we also require the radius of this wire. To do this, use screw gauge and measure the diameter of the metal wire at 3 different places. At each point, measure the diameter in 2 mutually perpendicular directions and make a table. This quantity is highly important to measure in this experiment because a small error in this parameter may cause a big error in your results. After that, we can apply this formula of modulus of rigidity when we have gathered all the parameters like L, A, M2, M1, R, T2 and T1 for finding the value of modulus of rigidity of this material. The value of modulus of rigidity for some of the well-known metals is available in the literature, so I am providing them in a table. You can use these values as the standard value and also find out the percentage error in your findings using this formula. In this way, you can easily find out the modulus of rigidity of the material of the wire using Maxwell's needle. Thanks for watching. Please keep supporting through your donations and your likes and shares. Have a good day.